SketchUp to Sketchy style in 10 minutes. So starting with your SketchUp model, for example, here we have a powder room. First thing to do is unhide all. I've got my ceiling hidden right now. Okay, and then what we want to do is go into tools section, and we want to create a section that looks through the way that we want our image to be. So in this room, I'm doing it looking as if you were walking in from the door. So this looks good. Great. Now right click on your section plane and you want to do align view. And this aligns the camera to that section cut. Then turn off the section plane and now let's zoom in so that our room is taking up the whole of our view space. Okay, now what you want to do is go into your shadows and turn on use sun for shading. And then where you have light, turn that up to 100. And where you have dark, do a high number like 80 or 90 so that it all looks good. You can also experiment with the time of day and year to see exactly what shading you want. And now we have something that's very light in textures. So now go ahead and turn off the textures in view. And now do file, save, export, export. And you want to make sure the height of the image is something like 3000. Okay, done. Now we need to create our second image. The next one will be our line work. This is our textures. So for line work, you want to go into styles, sketchy edges, and find the loose pen style, or rather pen loose. And now we have this style is active. You want to again turn off section plane and now tick profiles, increase the detail, and then do file export and save the line work as a second image. Now that we have this saved, let's import both of these as layers into the Photoshop image. So drag both so that they are on top of each other exactly. And now we have two layers. I'm going to call the first one textures and the second one line work. So one has our textures and all of our color, and the second has just the line work as such. So the line work is on top right now. What we will need to do is go ahead and use a layer blending so that if we use darken or multiply, only the black lines will show through and we'll be able to see the textures underneath. So I think that's good. Now, one thing you can do if the lines look very thin or they're too faint for what you're imagining, you can actually duplicate the line work layer. As such, and now all of your line work will appear a lot thicker and darker than before. And then what you could also do is merge those two layers that are the same and then make it your multiply again. So what you now want to do is add some sketchiness or painted style to the textured layer. And we do that by adding a mask. And then we will start by using the brush tool and start painting parts that we wish to mask out to reduce their texturedness and their color. So I'm going to go ahead and do a few bits, say for example the skirting, the edges of the section, almost as if the color as you were painting this has been left out around the corners of the image. And then also reduce some of the color in some of the stronger parts, like the panels to the side of the mirrors, to the ceiling, the coffer and the cornice. And then the walls, which are quite blank, so maybe we can use this masking to add some variety to the colors. A And so once you have it quite light and quite varied, you can always start to see the difference from what you had before. Like, this is already looking quite more conceptual and more hand painted. So now that we've lightened out and masked the textures, we want to add some shadows. So to do shadows again, you create a new layer called shadows, and I'm going to use the paintbrush tool again, a bit smaller. And I'm just going to start with a very light flowing brush and add some shadows, very rough. Like, you can take your time doing this, you can add more detail, or you can do it very quickly and it seems to come out okay, even if you just do some quick rough shadows, for example around the gap in the vanity, around the picture frame on the wall, and also in the corners of the room. And then inside the toilet and the bidet bowl, and then maybe a bit more in the corners where the light wouldn't hit. And then I'll probably drop the opacity just a bit on that shadows layer. Okay, now we want to add some lighting. So we've got these wall lights. So first thing I can do is make the brush quite a lot larger, have a slightly yellowish color selected, and then just brush on top of where we have those light fittings. And I'll use one of the hard light, or the soft light, probably the hard light. Hard light looks good. Overlays, so you get that nice glow. And then I think I'll also do the same in this coffer. So this is where we would have like an LED running around to get some diffused light into this powder room. I'm just going to go back and add some more masking to the textures, because I think it can become a bit more varied and look a bit more hand-drawn. So you'll see I'm whiting out some more of the floor and the vanity and the walls, and then maybe the corners as well. That looks good. And now what I've realized is we have these bronze trims running around the walls, and I think it's really nice, as if it was done by hand, to definitely keep those in color so that they really stand out. So I'm going to get rid of any of the masking we've done for those and keep them very prominent in this image. And you can do that when you have the mask. You can always delete parts of the mask that you've painted on. Then add some more shadows in the shadow gap in the vanity. Okay, so one other thing we need to do is create a reflection in the mirror. So back in SketchUp, I'm going to create another section cut, and I'm going to move it slightly into the room. Then right click align view, and we want to align our camera view like that, and turn off the section itself, turn off the edges. And now let's go ahead and save this as a third image from this model. So now that you have this image, let's bring that into our SketchUp model. And you can place the image and apply a mask to the layer. So magic wand the surface of the mirror, and then click your mask. And now you've created a mask that only shows through the area of the mirror. So we want to unlink it, and now we can move around the image without moving the mask itself. So the mirror will always stay as with the mask, but we can move the scale of our image. So I think we're going to move it into place. That looks fairly realistic. And just drop the opacity so it's more like a reflection. And now the next thing to do is to add a mask around the image. So we want it to look like a section. So I'm going to select the black section cut from SketchUp, and then also select the other sides of this image that don't have anything we want to show in them. So with the marquee tool, that is all selected. And now just press the paint bucket, fill it all in white, and now we have a white masking around the whole image on this layer. And I can add a stroke in layer styles to create what looks like a section line. So I think I'll make it a bit thicker. And I'll make it a bit gray. And then we just have these small bits by the skirting board that we'll manually paint bucket fill in, which we missed in the magic wanding of the section. So once we go do those, we'll have a nice section line around our section cut that will keep the image looking nice and clean. And so once you have this, you now have a hand-drawn effect image from SketchUp.